Hi, welcome to this short video. It's a tutorial where we're gonna go through the source code of an example using the BindsNet library. It is called a self-organizing maps example. Very interesting. First of all, I'll tell you quickly about BindsNet. BindsNet here is, as this says, it's a spiking neural network simulation library geared towards the development of biologically inspired algorithm for machine learning, which is a very good definition of what BindsNet truly is. And it runs on GPU and CPU thanks to PyTorch. Here it is. So first, it is inspired by the paper called Unsupervised Learning with Self-Organizing Spiking Neural Networks. This is where we're gonna get the mechanism for the learning, the unsupervised learning. The example runs on the MNIST dataset, the handwritten digits dataset. Okay, so let's have a look, quick look at the structure of a network. Input and output layer, that's it. Input is fully connected all to all to the output layer. And then the output layer is connected back to itself through a recurrent connection and provides only inhibition. Okay, so this is basic structure. The thing is, the output neurons inhibit themselves according to a rule, and the strength of the weights is defined here. They are proportional to the square root of the distance between all the neurons, and this is how, through the training, the output neurons arrange themselves in self-organizing maps, since the name. You will end up with something like this. The output neurons organize themselves, and when most of them, like in the 7 region, fired, it's usually a 7 that is presented at the input. This is the goal of our training, and it works pretty good. So now we can have a look at the source itself. Here we start importing the usual Torch and Torch Vision, because BindsNet uses this framework, TQDM because it looks very nice, and of course BindsNet. The four arguments for this example here, the number of output neurons, 900 is a good number. You can try to raise it 2000, 3000, you don't get that much better results, but you can try. The time is the duration in milliseconds of the simulation of the network. Intensity represents the maximum frequency when you convert the pixel intensity in spike frequency. And of course, epochs is the number of epochs we want to train our network on through the entire dataset. Here, very interesting batch size, 100. It means that in this source code, we can train our network 100 samples at a time, which is much faster, but beware not to have batch size too high, then the learning may become not as steady, not so stable. So usually 100 is a good number. Test interval, which means that every 1,000 sample we will test and we will evaluate the accuracy of our network. And every 500 sample we will slowly increase the inhibition of the recurrent connection on the output layer. Here are the two parameters for the initial setup of this inhibition. Well, if a GPU is available, we might as well use it. It will speed things up, like badly. And here we go, we start creating our network. The only required parameter is the batch size. We then create our first input layer. It's an input node, the usual shape, 2828. 784 neurons. Traces have to be true because there are training going on, and this is the time decay for these traces. We just add it to our network and we name it X. Then same goes for output layer, but this time it's the kind of neurons that we're gonna use is the Diehl and Cook neurons from the paper from 2015. You have the link up here if you wanna have a look. Same goes here, we need to have the traces on, and we just have a simple change here for the reset voltage of these neurons. We just add it to our network and we call it Y. Here is the input connection. input-output connection. It's what we call connection is actually fully connected system. Every neuron is connected to every other neuron from the other layer. Here are the two layers. You just set up the initial weights here, about 0.1, and with the size of the connection. Interesting, the learning rule, what we call the update rule. Here we use POSPRE, which stands for STDP learning, which is this standard way of teaching the neurons. Learning rate is here, we call it nu. Negative and positive rates in this order. This is how we accumulate all the learning from the batch. We just sum them up and we clamp these weights to a minimum and maximum of 0 and 1, and we normalize the connection weights just to make sure that every output neuron has exactly a 0.1 total weight from the input layer. We add this connection to our network. Then we will compute what I was talking about, which is the inhibition. Here it's proportional to the square of the distance between the neurons. So we will just set up this weights here. This is what we do here. We have power, and we make sure that the diagonal, which means that every neuron has no effect on itself. The diagonal is null, is just zero. Here we create the initial inhibition values. We add this recurrent connection to our network between layer Y and Y. And here we create a weight mask for increasing the inhibition. We use it to slowly adapt and add inhibition and more inhibition. Again, we take care not to have the diagonal, we'll leave it untouched. Okay, network is ready. We put it on the device, CPU or GPU. We print a nice summary of our network and we're good to go. Let's start by running it, by the way. Here we get the data set ready. We use the Poisson encoder to convert the intensity to the from pixel intensity to spike frequency. We download it if necessary. Here's the intensity. And we set up a monitor to get the spikes from the output layer, from the Y layer. And we're going to record the S value, which are the spikes value for the duration of the simulation. We add this monitor to our network. Data loader is ready using PyTorch again. We just have to provide the batch size. Spike records, labels. We need to put them aside. Every test interval, we're going to evaluate the quality, the accuracy of this network. Default accuracy is 0.1 for the random answer one might give. Again, here, rate proportion assignment. These are the three values that we need to evaluate which neurons fire for which digit. This is just statistical analysis of the output. And we're good to go. We run through the epochs and through the data loader, the entire data set. If I repass, we get the input, which are now encoded. We just permute it because we need to have time as the first dimension upfront. And we reset all of our network, make sure that everything is at default value or rest value. And we run our network here, finally, providing the inputs and the duration of our simulation. We add the labels and spike records, put them aside. And when we want to test it here, we just ask a network for this prediction, ypred. So every test interval, we make this evaluation. Algorithm is called proportion weighting, based on proportion of the output networks that fires the most regarding the input numbers. Accuracy is just smoothed out here. When the labels are good, we just print it out. So now I have it running somewhere here. I have already, while I'm talking to you, 24% for about 2 minutes, 2 minutes learning, which is cool. And just the entire mechanism of progressive increasing inhibition is here. So every 500 samples, we slowly increase, using the weight mass that we created, we increase the inhibition from Y to Y. And this is the mechanism of the self-organizing maps. But every 10 times 500, every 5,000 samples, then we make a huge bump in this curve, and we speed up the increasing the inhibition to have fewer and fewer neurons firing, and just to select the most meaningful, the most significant output neurons to fire. So when I'm talking here, I'm getting 32%, which is nice. Usually at the end of first epoch, you would get 86-88%. And at the end of second epoch, usually something like 91-93%, if you get lucky. And this is pretty much state of the art for unsupervised learning. Well, I hope you like this video, and I hope you have a good time working, playing, and experimenting with VinesNet, which is a beautiful library for experimenting, spiking neural networks. Thank you.